In this video, I'm going to try my hand at Canva and use the free version to make t-shirts online for absolutely free. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And my channel is all about helping you to learn how to design and sell t-shirts online. If that's something you want to learn more about, don't forget to hit that subscribe button right there. So in this video, I'm going to do it. I'm finally going to try Canva. I opened it up. I signed up today, this morning, and I took a look at it, tried it out for a few minutes, and I'm going to show you what I've learned so far on Canva. I'm not an expert on Canva. Like I said, I just started it, but I wanted to show you all that you can make t-shirt designs for free on the internet. I know I use Affinity Designer a lot, and that's something that you can buy later. If you have an extra 50 bucks or so, you can buy Affinity Designer. I think it's a great deal. But for those of you that want to just get started and don't want to spend any money, a lot of people have been asking about Canva. Because there's a free version on Canva, all you have to do is sign up with your email and password and create an account, and you can use it to design t-shirts. So I'm going to show you how I would use it. I'm going to show you some of the things that you may want to know before using it for designing t-shirts. So there's a lot to see in this video, and I think it would be really helpful for those that are just getting started on print on demand. So let's get on the internet right now and on Canva. So first of all, this is what you would see if you went to canva.com. If you haven't signed up, they'll ask you to sign up here or log in. And you can try Canva for free for 30 days, the premium version for 30 days. But if you just sign up, you'll get this free version right here. And you can see there's a lot of things. There's 250,000 templates. So there's a lot to get started and learn about it. But if you want some other stuff, some upgrades here, it's going to cost you $12.99 a month. And some people, I mean, there are a lot of stuff in here if you want to use some of these things. I just think, you know, after paying 3 months of this, you can get into Affinity Designer. So depending on your skill level, Affinity Designer, you will have to, you know, draw your own graphics or grab graphics and things like that. Whereas Canva comes with a lot of graphics, but you have to understand that everybody with Canva has those graphics as well. So there's a give and take there. There's some things on the premium stuff you'll see later in the video that you'll need the premium or the pro version. You'll see this crown everywhere. I'll show you where the different things for the crowns are. I've noticed that on the free version of Canva, looking at these, this is free and this isn't, this is pro and this isn't, those kind of things. So I'll show you that when I do my design. So I'm gonna log in here. You can sign up. It just takes an email and a password, and you can pause the video and come back, and then we'll just get started after logging in. You can see I played with it this morning and made a couple of designs, so I learned a few things before doing this video. The one thing that you might be tempted with or think that you would want to do when doing t-shirts is to click on here to click on t-shirts, but that's not the right thing to do because it's a small size. So the t-shirt size on Canva is really small. So what you want to do is create a custom size for the Merch by Amazon size. You see right here, I made mine 4,500 by 5,400. I did the t-shirt size first and realized it was too small. And then I did this size, which is the right size for print on demand, at least for Merch by Amazon. You don't need it that big for Redbubble or other places, but you might as well, if you have Merch by Amazon, you might as well make it that size so you can use it on everything else. So here's what you do. You hit custom size right here, or you can hit create design and go to custom size. You may not see it right here, but here's custom size at the bottom. It's big and bold right here. You may think, oh, click on t-shirt 14 by 18. It's not at the right pixel size again, so that's the wrong size. So click this custom size, and this is what's going to happen. You get to type in your own size. So you're going to want to type in 4,500 by 5,400 tall. And you used to not be able to make it this size in Canva a while ago. I don't know when they changed it, but now you can make it this size, which is perfect. So you don't have to go to somewhere and resize your stuff. You can make it the exact same size. So that's something really cool that Canva updated. I don't know when, but they did it. Oh, and if you've done it already, you can see I did a recent one. So it will always be there and kind of saves what you do. So create design. And so now this is your stuff right here. And This can add a page if you want multiple pages. We don't need that for t-shirts. And this also can duplicate your page, which we won't need for t-shirts. So let's do this right here. We can come over here to elements and we can use lines or photos or graphics or videos. Obviously you can't put a video on a t-shirt or audio. So those two aren't gonna really help you. But Canva is very powerful to do some of those other stuff. So if you're on Instagram, Facebook and things like that, you may wanna do those kinds of things. But let's just stick to graphics. And you can see right here, these are pro. Whenever you see this right here, these crowns, those are pro stuff. You can also type in, I have line right here, but let's say we wanna do something Christmassy. So we can just type in Christmas and it'll pull up all the different things for Christmas here. So I think I used this light last time. So you just click on it and it appears right here. You could also drag it. So you can also delete it right here. If you pick here and drag it, you can do that. And you can size it very easily in Canva by just grabbing these ends and stretching it. Okay, let's look for something else that I wanna put on here. We can do anything. I didn't do any research on what to put in here. I'm just gonna show you how to do it. And then you're gonna have to do the research on what kind of t-shirts actually sell. So you can't just put up designs here and think they're gonna sell. Make sure you do the research first to see what's selling, what people actually wanna buy, and then make your t-shirt. But I'm kind of doing it backwards here. So let's see. I think the one that I wanted here. Oh, I know what I did. I think I did Christmas. Merry Christmas. Yeah, so if you do Merry Christmas, take a look at some of these things right here. Some of these are really cool. And a lot of them are very intricate. And I'm gonna tell you right now, don't do very intricate stuff unless you have the pro version, because we're gonna have to take out some of the background and it's gonna be very hard to take out the background with some of this intricate stuff. But this is really cool. I'm gonna delete that right now. I'm gonna find something just a little bit easier to knock out. Let's do this, Merry and Bright. That's really cool. All right, you can make that big and move this down. Whoops, it's okay. This is kind of cool. All right, and then I think if you hold Option and drag, yes, it copies it, and then hopefully you can flip it. Let's see. Yes, that's kind of cool right there, right? Now, one of the things you might want to do is sometimes the colors aren't going to match. So let me just get this straight. They're 180. There, that looks like a cool t-shirt, right? So this is how it works. You click on here and pick the color that you see. See, these are the light colors. If you did this, these are the merry and bright colors. So let's click on here and click on this, double click it. And you can see I'm gonna change that color to this color, right? Just like that. So that's how you can change colors here. You can also write a text. So let's do something, show you the text tool. Let's see, merry and bright. I don't know, you can use these right here for the font. So if you wanna use this font right here, let's pull it down. No, and then just use that. Merry and bright, love and joy, or whatever you want. You can type whatever you want here. But let's say you wanna make this color red, you could too. Now this one's also gonna be really hard. You don't wanna do thin ones, or at least make it bigger here. So that could be cool. Now if you wanna make this on a black background or a red background, you can. So let's change the background color right here. You know, it's white right now. Let's say we want it, you know, more red like that. But then some of these are not sticking out. So what we can do here is now take that color and make it red. See that? Take this color and color it right here. Make that white. See how that's gonna work on a red right here? So you can do things like that. So there's my t-shirt design. I kind of like that. Merry and bright, love and joy. I don't know who would buy that, but that's what I'm going for right now. I'm going to show you what you need to do next. So first of all, you're going to export this. So you're going to hit download right here, and it's the size 4500 by 5400. You can see if I make it bigger. Well, I can't make it bigger. It's going to ask you, try Canva Pro, then you can make it bigger, right? So we don't need it any bigger. And you can see the transparent background, that's a feature of the Pro version with this crown here. To compress files, that's the feature of this Pro version here. Save download settings, you can, that's a good thing. Okay, and then PNG is what you want, but this PNG's, you know, isn't gonna have the transparent background that we need. So I'm gonna show you how you can do it for free on a Mac if you have a Mac. So let's download this and then I'll show you what to do on a Mac. So here's my Merry and Bright t-shirt design that we did. You can see there's the red background here. But if we put that red background on a t-shirt, it's gonna have that rectangle and we don't want that. We want the red to be the t-shirt and not the background. So what you can do here is I have it open up in preview on my Mac. I just double click the PNG file and it does it automatically. Then you can click this right here. This is kind of the toolbar, opens up the toolbar. And then you want this right here, which is the instant alpha. Click on that. And then you wanna click on this red right here and kind of scroll back. You see how things are changing color like that? That's doing the alpha for the whole thing. Come back and you want it so it doesn't do everything, just the red. So once you start seeing something change color, look very closely. There, don't do that. Go just a little bit back. And I think, oh no, we did it too far. Let's do it again. There we go. That worked. So you can see these marching ants, it's going around the design, right? So now we can hit delete or backspace and it's knocked out. But didn't you still see some red right here in the middle of these fonts? So we're gonna have to go in and do the same thing here. So click on here and do that. You see the marching ants, delete, delete, and so on. Let me do this real quick. All right, so I think I got everything. That's the way you can knock everything out, just free in preview, didn't cost anything. If you don't have a Mac, I believe you can go online and find a thing called Pixlr. I believe that's for PCs, and you can do kind of the same thing for free. I haven't used it because I'm not on a PC, but that's what I've learned on YouTube after watching some YouTube videos. So here it is, love and joy. We're just gonna save this with the background knocked out, and I'm gonna pull this into Merch by Amazon and upload it so you can see what it looks like on a t-shirt. So here we are on Merch by Amazon. Take a look at this. I'm gonna click edit details so it looks a little bigger. Let's go right here. You can see it does a pretty good job. I'm not totally zoomed in. Let's see if I can do it. Yeah, I can zoom in here. And it looks really good. It looks pretty good here. And that was for free. So let's back up and let's look what the different colors are. So you can see now it's knocked out. Asphalt, black, looks really good on black. Cranberry, that's probably the one I would get here. Green, you know, some of the colors won't work, like yellow, don't click that, that doesn't work. So this is what I do. You would pick up to 10 colors on Merch by Amazon. No, not that one, nope, not that one. Doesn't work on white. Royal kind of looks good, red. Purple kind of looks good. Oh, I got more than 10 colors, but we'll come back in here. Maybe not that green, maybe not brown. Okay, so there. But you can pick your 10 colors. But you can see we did it all for free on Canva. You can type any different things. Again, do your research first. This isn't something that people wanna buy. I mean, maybe it's something people wanna buy, but I didn't do any research up front. I just picked Merry and Bright, Love and Joy, and see what happens, right? So, and then make sure these colors are the colors that you want and things like that. So it's gonna take just a little bit longer up front, but you can see I did it pretty quick on Canva and it was totally free and they have all those graphics. I didn't even get into some of the other graphics. You can type in different keywords and things like that. So this is a very good place to start. for people who don't want to spend any money right away and want to just get started. Just jump in and make your designs, and you can get started with Redbubble again and put these on there too. So totally free on Redbubble to start and totally free with Canva to start. So there's no excuses on not starting a print-on-demand shop right now because you have all the tools you need for free. So that is it for this video. Hopefully you learned something about Canva. I really like the idea that you can start with something for free. A lot of people have been asking me to make this video, trying to do t-shirt designs on Canva. Now that I have a Canva account, I can start doing more and more tutorials on it. This one was very basic. I just picked some things on there. I didn't do any research. So I'm gonna show you some other things that you can do in the future. Let me know if you wanna see other things on Canva. If you guys are using Canva, let me know in the comments as well as some things that you wanna learn on Canva. I'm just starting out. Like I said, I just started this morning, so I still have lots to learn on Canva, but those are the basic things that you can do just to get started. And you can see it turned out pretty good even on Merch by Amazon and gave that right size. So hopefully this video was really helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. That really helps in the algorithm. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there so you can see all my videos. And before I leave, I wanted to leave with a question of the day. And the question of the day is this. What applications do you use to create your designs? I know I use Affinity Designer. I just showed Canva, but there's so many other things out there. I think there's Illustrator. People use a lot there. I may have to do some tutorials there. Let me know in the comments what other application tutorials that you want to learn how to use, and hopefully I can get some of those out too. So thanks so much for watching. If you want to see more t-shirt design tutorials or other things for print on demand, make sure to click these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.